Welcome back to Broadscope Gaming. I'm on a boat, and we're back with Resident Evil 5. Now then, we're actually getting pretty close to the end. There are still things to do after that, but it's a nice little milestone. Anyway, welcome to the ship deck. This will be pretty much the last actual level. Sorry, more recreational. Explosives. Just getting everything upgraded. We're actually pretty close to getting the final upgrade for quite a few things. The shotgun I'm hoping comes after this level, but it might not. The weapon awarded for completing the Ithaca is actually one of the favorites of players in this game. Now I know for sure this thing has only one upgrade left, unless they decide to troll you and suddenly reduce it back. Its max capacity is 300. Anyway, that's enough about inventory. Sticking with the AK, so. Alright, let's get going. Anyway, to finish the thought on why this is the last actual level. Well, long story short, while the game has been pretty linear beforehand, it's about to get so very much more linear. However, this level does have plenty of turns and paths, as well as a few secret things you can do.
This ship is huge. Do you think they're planning to use it to spread Ouroboros?
No. Using a ship like this would give away their position too soon. We must have another plan.
Ow. Joik. There we go. Oh, right. These jerks. All right. Sorry about that. This is part of what I mean by it not being as linear as the last few levels. In the last few levels, you basically, it's a what you see is what you get type deal.
Take it.
Roger.
Take it.
Okay.
Here you can actually go out of your way to do a few things. Although admittedly with the game as linear as it is before, it's not too heavy a difference, so. But anyway, I'm going to take one of my last vestiges of freedom. Also, if you do it right, then basically you can stealth through this section by sniping targets. A little like before. And speaking of sniping targets, this is going to save us a lot of trouble. Okay, good. I'll point out where that came into play. Anyway. Also, the hardest BASAA emblem in the game to hit. See that tiny blue thing there? That's it. Now then, the latest sniper rifle we got can actually have its zoom enhanced. And that can make it much easier to nail the thing, but as you just saw, you don't need it to hit that target. It's just very helpful. Bad dog. Down. Down. Gee, they're sure are dropping a lot of flash grenades. He was unsured. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and stop being coy. There is a new mutation that will commonly show up. There it is. Duavola. I believe there are only two places it can show up before this, and even then it's exceptionally rare. So... but yes, that counts as exposed parasite, even though the naming makes a bit less sense considering how unexposed it is. Otherwise, it is basically the shell is rock hard armor and you need to shoot the inside. You need to shoot the inside of its mouth, which you get to open by shooting its legs. But using a flash grenade will instantly kill them. Have I said how much I love flash grenades recently? Oh no, we can't open the door. Another partner movement space? So what exactly is that doing on a ship? Are they building something? Oh look, a first aid spray.
Give me a grenade. Come on!
Okay. Yep, so those enemies I killed.
Take it.
Roger.
They're actually right up there. They're behind the locked doorway. Should you not have gone out of your way to snipe them, what you'd have to do instead is, I believe your partner would always run. Also BSA emblem in there, but you need an explosive. Which I don't have any. Flash grenades and incendiary grenades do not count, weirdly enough.
Take it.
Okay.
But a cage would fall, and I believe they intentionally make your partner run faster than you after the push so that you cannot get in front of them. And then you would have to get your partner free by going up to the controls, which was behind the locked door. Also, the treasure I got was the reward for shooting the guy off the top of the thing. So. It takes longer and it will leave one of your partners trapped. guys. Kneel. Kneel before your new emperor. The blood of the river god flows within me. You cannot possibly hope to win. You can also not possibly hope to win. So this is another split up. It's a lot shorter. Perfect. So yeah, that, by the way, that was what I was wrong about. A flash grenade will instantly kill an exposed dog like that, but electricity will not. Just a little shortcut you can open back that way, in case your partner is too dumb. Sheva, why do you make me cry? Sheva doesn't make me cry in the, oh, what a touching scene kind of way. She makes me cry in a, I'm supposed to expect this person to save my life type way. Ooh. More money. Alright. Sorry about that. I'm just trying to remember all the details of that. And then there's this. Alright, since it's saved there, I will go ahead and do some inventory management. New treasure, I missed the other topaz oval. There are two from both the guys we shot up there, but whatever. I think we're good. Just clearing out some inventory. Huh. That's weird. I never knew you could ruin the display like that.
Take it,
Roger.
All right, down some long stairs.
He knows we're here. He'll find us.
And how do you know that?
Let's just say we have a history together, and he's not the type to let grudges go.
Hmm. He must have done something to really piss him off.
It goes a bit beyond just pissing him off.
So, are you going to tell me what happened?
Maybe. But not until
I'll tell you about my ex-boyfriend later, Sheva.
Deal?
Roger, okay. But I'm holding you to that.
All right.
Freeze!
What's going on here?
Nothing that concerns either of you.
We're not giving you an option. Now spit it out.
Tell us what we want to know and you won't get hurt. Where's Wesker?
If you can behave yourselves, maybe I'll tell you.
Oh no, she's running. At least they actually made an effort to put a bullet in her.
Damn it!
She's tough. I'll give her that much.
Oh yeah, she is. That's why I main her in mercenaries. PG-67. Jeez, you have to be old to view this.
Whatever it is, Excella seemed protective of it.
Alright, so yes. That was a thing. Just gonna clear out this inventory so it stops dropping shotgun shells. Anyway, this is the Jailbreaker. The last findable shotgun in the game. So that is the last shotgun you can find out in the game. And if I remember correctly, it's actually the very last weapon you can find lying around in the game. Everything else must be bought. So handguns, the only one laying out is this. You got the Ithaca, the M3, and the Jailbreaker for the shotguns. Machine guns, we have the VZ-61, the MP5, the 5.56, and the AK, which I'm using. Sniper rifles, we have the bolt action S-75, Drugnog FZD, and the PSG-1. Magnums is the Smith & Wesson M29 and the Lightning Hawk, with this being viable. And then rocket launcher. I have a few saved up for raisins. So. Also, as with any new weapon, once we've picked it up on the ground, we can buy it. I'm not exactly sure, but I think the way it works is if it's picked up by either person in a party, you can then buy it, but if not, then once you complete the level, it'll automatically be added to the store. Anyway. I believe that is the very last BSAA emblem if you were collecting them all in order.
Thanks for the help.
Come on!
Roger!
So, welcome to good intention, poor execution. This is basically another stealth puzzle, where you have to kill people in the right order. Unfortunately, I have no clue what the freaking right order is. Do it right and it will not summon extra enemies and they will not figure out where you are. Do it wrong, like I'm pretty sure I'm about to, and this cutscene plays, and several more of them will pop up. I believe it is if you take too long after killing the first person after entering Dreamstar. Ow! Joik. Also, the machine guns can do pretty bad damage to you. I believe the guy who approached me with the stun baton is the last one I had to take out. I forget where he was, though. But yeah, had it been done correctly, then there'd be no one else. No time. Snapping your neck. Nah. now. Okay, who threw that? Don't tell me what to do, Sheva. You're worse than I am. Ah, there you are. Anyway, those with grenades on their vest can be shot in a grenade in the grenade to forcibly blow them up. Not always an easy target, though. There we go. Also, another note, I believe grenade types are always melees. They will always carry around a stun rod. Of course I aim at his nut to steal first. Why, thank you. Wow, buddy. Also, I believe that the fact that he took 4 hits instead of 3, which is otherwise the max, is an indication that he was a pre-scripted mutation. Oh, my rifle's getting nice exercise today. There we go.
The weapons keep getting bigger. Take cover.
Say hello to the last of the jerks, Chainsaw Majini. His weakness is his head. Keep shooting him in the head, and he will keep getting stunned. It's a little dangerous to try to do the stun locking like I've just been, because it always gives you the combo finisher, but he's actually dangerous at any range. If you get too close, he will use the chain gun essentially as a gigantic club. If you're too far away, he'll use the chain gun as a freaking chain gun. Surprising, I know. You might think it's a little late to introduce that as a boss, but don't worry, he'll get another moment in the sun. Sheva, quit being a kleptomaniac. Anyway, you need 2 key cards. The other one is in the safe I ran to.
Rocket launcher!
These guys take 2 hits, 2 arm shots each. I skipped the cutscene, but it was literally just them shooting a rocket launcher and blowing up one of the crates. Yeah, I like to take care of this room quickly because they will eliminate all of your cover if you let them. That was just another hiding spot over there.
Come on, Roger.
Yeah, Sheva, hurry. That is a slightly amusing consequence of the call partner over button and the start up a team action button being the exact same thing.
Too bad you won't make it much further.
The news appearing of
backstory explained.
Given birth by the progenitor virus.
Yeah, I'm not going to skip it. I'm just going to go ahead and explain the whole thing. Wesker children were all genetically modified.
Of them, only one survived. You.
Also, Spencer is lying about that.
I was to become a god. Creating a new world with an advanced race of human beings. However, all was lost.
By the way, this is what I was saying about Umbrella being a cavalcade of fuck-ups.
Despite that setback, your creation still holds great significance.
Literally, they unleash zombies trying to become immortal and push humans onto another level using this admittedly very interesting
ironic
virus.
Isn't it? For one who has the right to be a god. To face his own mortality.
What are those wires hooked to?
The right to be a god.
Oh yeah, say hello to the Resident Evil 5 Wesker signature move.
Is now mine.
In the one in the battle after the Lickers, had you failed against Wesker, I believe he would have employed it. Although it's also quite possible he wouldn't have.
Even until the end. Only one truly capable of being a god deserves that right.
Also, as far as Spencer lying about there being remaining Wesker children, in the Lost in Nightmares DLC, which I don't think I'll be showing off, I'm not that good at it. You saw me unlock it earlier.
I have.
Explains that there's actually another Wesker working for Spencer. His name was Alex. However, he left long before the conflict that takes place within the DLC, or just shown there. So, Spencer basically wrote him off as dead and lied to Wesker about there being another Wesker child. Alright, that's it for now. We'll continue on later. For now, cheers.